Now, let us begin our class with Brahmanad. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Good morning, children. In our today's class, we will go through the second unit of the lesson In London in Minus Force by Louis Fisher. In our previous class, we discussed that Gandhiji was chosen as the sole delegate to attend the second roundtable conference held in London from 7th September to 1st December 1931. Excuse me. So he sailed from Bombay on SS Rajputna on 29 August 1931. But he was not alone when he went to London to attend the second roundtable conference. He was accompanied by his youngest son, Devdas Gandhi, his chief secretary, Mahadev Desai, whom he called out Boswell, Boswell. And you know, out Boswell, Boswell means John Boswell was a famous diarist of England, and the chief secretary of Mahatma Gandhi, Mahadev Desai, outshone or surpassed in the art of keeping diaries. That was the reason why Mahatma Gandhi called his chief secretary Mahadev Desai out Boswell, Boswell. Miss Slade, then Pyarelal Nair, G.D. Birla, Madan Mohan Malviya and Sarojini Naidu also accompanied Mahatma Gandhi when he went to London in 1931 to attend the second roundtable conference. See, we know that Muriel Lester visited India in 1926, and when he visited India in 1926, he had met Mahatma Gandhi. So there grew a relationship between Mahatma Gandhi and Muriel Lester. And when Mahatma Gandhi went to London to attend the second roundtable conference, he stayed in his Kingsley Hall as his guest from 12th September till 5th December 1931. While staying at the guest of Muriel Lester in his Kingsley Hall, he used to go for his morning walks to the nearby slum areas, and how he engaged the people when they gave a smile to him in conversations. And when children asked him, why you have not put on trousers, he did not say anything, but he only had a merry laugh. Now, let us go through this unit 2. Clear? We know that Mahatma Gandhi was a man of simple living and high thinking. He was very humble in dress and very simple in manners. At the same time, he had a unique approach to his goal of complete freedom for our country, India. See, after going there, he was found surrounding all the time by the reporters. Reporters surrounded him all the time because they expected some news element from Mahatma Gandhi. So here it is called, he was a wonderful newspaper copy. Was called a wonderful newspaper copy. It was Mahatma Gandhi who was called a wonderful newspaper copy. Why was he called a wonderful newspaper copy? Because the reporters thought that he was a news element from whom they would get some headlines to be published in their newspapers. That was the reason why he was called a wonderful newspaper copy. That was the reason journalists buzzed, B-U-Z-Z-E-D, buzzed means talked noisily around him, incessantly. Incessantly means without stopping or continuously. Who buzzed around Mahatma Gandhi incessantly? The reporters surrounded Mahatma Gandhi incessantly all the time because they thought that they would get some news items to be published in their newspapers. One reporter questioned Gandhi about his dress one day when he was in London during his stay in Kingsley Hall, as he had gone to attend the second round table conference. One reporter questioned him about his dress. The reply was very interesting. The reply of Mahatma Gandhi was very interesting. Mahatma Gandhi said, "You people wear plus fours, but mine are minus fours." See, in our previous class, I had said to you, don't think in minus fours means the weather condition of the country. Here, minus fours means the dress of Mahatma Gandhi. When Mahatma Gandhi was asked about his dress by a reporter, he said to him, "You people, you the Britishers, you the English people, wear plus fours." Plus four. Here, plus four means suit, shirt, hat, and tie. But mine are minus fours. Minus fours means your loincloth, cloth that covers only up to knees, a shawl to cover the body, and a dangling watch and the slippers. That was the dress of Mahatma Gandhi when he went to London to attend the second roundtable conference in 1931. When he was invited to tea in Buckingham Palace with King George V and Queen Mary, all England was agog over what he would wear. When he had gone to attend the second roundtable conference in London, he was invited by King George V and Queen Mary in their Buckingham Palace. And when he was invited as the guest of King George V and Queen Mary, all the people of England were agog. Agog means excited. A-G-O-G. Agog means excited to know what Mahatma Gandhi would wear when going to the Buckingham Palace to have tea with King George V and Queen Mary. Usually, we people, under people, what do? When we are invited by the great personalities or VIPs, we wear new dresses, good dresses to impress others. But Gandhiji was not so. So all the people of England were very much excited to see what Mahatma Gandhi would wear while going to the Buckingham Palace to have tea with King George V and Queen Mary. He wore his usual dress. And what was his usual dress? His usual dress was loincloth, the cloth that covers up to his knees, and a shawl to cover his body, and a dangling dollar-shaped watch and slippers. And you know, dangling means hanging loosely. And a dollar watch means what? Dollar watch means dollar-like round-shaped pocket watch. So that was the usual dress of Mahatma Gandhi when he went to London in 1931 to attend the second roundtable conference. So what was his dress? A loincloth, a shawl, a dangling dollar watch, and slippers. This is known as minus force. Here, what does minus force mean? Minus force refers to the dress of Mahatma Gandhi that he wore while staying in London when he had gone there to attend the second roundtable conference. And what was his dress? His dress was a loincloth, a shawl, a dangling dollar-shaped watch, and slippers. So all England was agog over what he would wear. He wore, past tense of wear, is wore, the usual loincloth, sandals, a shawl, and his dangling dollar watch. Subsequently means afterwards, someone asked Gandhiji whether he had enough on. Subsequently, someone, we don't know who is that person exactly, someone asked if he had put on enough clothes when he went to the Buckingham Palace to have tea with King George V and Queen Mary. Mahatma Gandhi replied very cleverly, the king had enough on for both of us. The king had put on enough clothes for both of us. The king had enough on for both of them. See how interestingly and how cleverly he answered the question asked to him about his dress by someone when he went to the Buckingham Palace to have his tea with King George V and Queen Mary. So this first paragraph is about his dress. Clear? He enjoyed himself everywhere, wherever he went. He enjoyed his life. Wherever we go, we should enjoy our life. We should know how to adjust ourselves in different situations, in different circumstances. Happiness cannot be purchased from the market. It is within us. How we enjoy ourselves depends on us. And Mahatma Gandhi enjoyed wherever he went. He enjoyed himself everywhere. He had his talks. Here, talks is used as a noun. He had his talks with the dignitaries or the great personalities. He did not ignore the labor class people. And you know, in the previous unit, during his morning walks, he engaged the people who were on their works, the labor class people who were on their works, and engaged them in conversations. And later on, he went to their homes. At the same time, he had also good relationship or contact with the dignitaries. He had talks with Lord Irwin, War time Prime Minister David Lloyd George, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Field Marshal Smuts, George Bernard Shaw, and scores of others. A score means a number of 20 numbers. And here scores of others means many others. So he had his conversation, he had his talks with the dignitaries while staying in London when he had gone there to attend the second roundtable conference. He had his talks with Lord Irwin, wartime Prime Minister David Lloyd George. He had his talks also with the Archbishop of Canterbury or the Pope. He had his talks with Field Marshal Smuts. He had his talks with George Bernard Shaw and many others. And at the same time, he went down into the country near Reading. Here Reading means what? A market town in Berkshire. He also went down into the country near Reading to pay his respects to Colonel Madoc. And when he had been his visit to London, he also paid his visit to Colonel Madoc. Because it was Colonel Madoc who had performed the appendectomy. Here, appendectomy means surgical removal of appendicitis. Appendectomy. So, he went down into the country near Reading only to have his visit in order to pay his respect to Colonel Madoc, because it was he who had performed the appendectomy of Mahatma Gandhi. So he went down into the country near Reading to pay his respects to Colonel Madoc, who had performed the appendectomy on him in Pune jail. So when Mahatma Gandhi was in Pune jail, it was Colonel Madoc who had performed the appendectomy on Gandhi. So when he went to London in 1931 to attend the second roundtable conference, he paid his visit. He made his visit to pay his respect to Colonel Madoc. But there was one personality in England who denied to meet with Gandhiji. And who was he? He was the then Prime Minister of England. It was Sir Winston Leonard Spencer Churchill. But Winston Churchill refused to see Mahatma Gandhi. He had his talks with many dignitaries and distinguished personalities in England, but one personality in England who denied to see him, and it was no other than the then Prime Minister of England, Sir Winston Leonard Spencer Churchill. He also addressed innumerable means large number, numerous public meetings. When he was in London, what did he do? He also gave his speeches. He also addressed innumerable public meetings. At the same time, he spent two memorable. Memorable means unforgettable. He also spent two unmemorable memories or unforgettable memories at Oxford University. He also addressed innumerable public meetings and spent two unforgettable weekends. Two unforgettable weekends at Oxford Universities. In these public meetings and private conversations. He tried to explain what he meant by the independence of India. His prime aim was to make people of England to know what did he mean by the independence of India. So in these public meetings and in the private conversations, he tried above all else to explain what he meant by the independence of India. He meant to cut completely the British rule in India. He did not want the British to rule in India. He wanted to end the British rule in India. He would cut India off means he wanted to end the British rule in India. He would cut India off from the British Empire entirely, means completely, but not from the British nation. He wanted that there should not be British rule in India. He wanted the end of British rule in India, but he did not want to cut off our relationship with the Britishers. He wanted that we should have our relationship with the Britishers. We should have good relationship with the Britishers. But he wanted to end the British rule in India. He would cut India off from the empire entirely. That means British Empire. From the British Empire entirely, not from the British nation. If I refers to Mahatma Gandhi, if I want India to gain, I don't want that we should cut up our relationship with the Britishers. We should have our relationship, good relationship with the Britishers, but we don't want the Britishers should rule us. We want the end of the British rule in India. If I want to gain and not to grieve or feel sad later, the emperorship must go. Your emperorship means power of the supreme ruler over subject nations. Power of the supreme ruler must go from India. The emperorship must go, and I should love to be an equal partner. He wanted that we should be the equal partner with Britain or with the Britishers, sharing joys and sorrows. He wanted that we should have our relationship with the Britishers, and we should be the equal partner with the Britain, sharing our sorrows and joys, and an equal partner with the dominions. Here dominions means self-governing countries of the British Commonwealth. Dominions, self-governing, self-ruling countries of the British Commonwealth. So he said, while addressing in public meetings and in private conversations, that the emperorship must go from India, and at the same time we the Indians should love to be an equal partner with Britain, sharing her joys and sorrows, and at the same time to be equal partner with the self-governing countries of British Commonwealth. But it must be a partnership on equal terms. He was describing precisely means exactly. He was describing precisely and with remarkable. Remarkable means what? Remarkable means praiseworthy prevision. It should not be precision. Precision, here precision is written. It should be prevision. And prevision means what? Foresight. The status free India assumed. Assumed means what? Adopt in the Commonwealth in 1948. Mahatma Gandhi went even further. He saw what many of his followers, many of the followers of Mahatma Gandhi have not yet discerned. Discerned means seen clearly. Seen, discern, see clearly. Discerned means seen clearly. Mahatma Gandhi even went further. What many of his followers have not yet discerned. Isolated independence. Isolated independence means freedom alone for its own sake. Freedom, isolated freedom. Freedom alone for its own sake. Isolated independence is not the goal. Our goal was not isolated independence. We want to have our relationship, our good relationship with other nations. We didn't want isolated independence. So isolated independence is not the goal he gave in his statements, or he told, he asserted. It is voluntary independence. Here voluntary independence means willing acceptance of mutual help. It should be willing acceptance of mutual help. It is voluntary independence. Liberated colonies, freedom, free colonies or countries or dominions so treasure their new found independence. They think what? They think it is a viable. Viable means feasible or capable of success. But the law of nature, that's the law of nature in love, friendship, work, progress, and security is the creative interdependence. Creative, it should not be voluntary interdependence, it should be creative interdependence, that is mutual, creative, mutual help. And there should be love, there should be friendship, work, progress, and security among the nations. Here mutual help, that is, one should help another in progress, in reality. Clear? Now, let me ask you a few questions. Why was Mahatma Gandhi called a wonderful newspaper copy? Mahatma Gandhi was called a wonderful newspaper copy because it was thought that he was a news element from whom the newspaper reporters would get news items for the publication in their newspapers. What was Gandhi's reply to the journalist's question about his dress? When he was asked about his dress, he said that you people wear plus fours but minus fours. You people wear extra clothes but mine are simple clothes. How was Gandhiji dressed when he went to see King George V? When he went to see King George V, he wore his usual clothes. That was a loincloth and a shawl to cover his body, slippers, and a dangling dollar watch. In our next class, we will go through Unit 3. That is the last unit of the lesson. Thank you all.